serious there, folks. You don't understand how that could affect the lives of people in your country, okay, when this kind of thing happens. And yes, it can happen here. I was in the nuclear business for too long. I know all the dirty little secrets, okay? And yes, it can happen here, okay? Trust me. I could tell you some nightmare stories, okay, about people using drugs, alcohol, you name it, while engaged in work at a nuclear power plant.
It is the 16th of the 3rd, 2013. And this is your radioactive reality for today. Let's go and get started on ENE News, just reading the headlines and going through. Fukushima internal contamination levels to rise in 5 to 10 years. Now, they did some studies in Chernobyl, and they're talking about the locals' ingestion, their internal radiation levels went down, and then 5 to 10 years later went right back up again kind of thing. And they're expecting the same things to happen in Japan. That is an underestimation with all the craziness that's going on in the food market in and around Japan and the entire world right now. Black radioactive material being reported 100 kilometers south of Fukushima Daiichi. Now, this is a radioactive bacteria that develops and mutates and gets real big, and it blows all over the place. They found it far back as Chernobyl. They did some studies back in 2007. I believe a link is attached in the comments on this story on ENE News. You got to go through some of these comments. There are some very intelligent people helping along with this whole subject all up and down the board. Thank you for everybody's help who is helping. Reports from California, something is going badly wrong offshore, quote-unquote. Stranding centers inundated with animals. Now, they're saying the seals and sea lions, the baby pups, are coming up on, and they're undernourished, and they're small, and they are in record numbers, more than El Nino ever wanted to be, as far as the serious crisis situation going on the west coast of the United States. We've got all this tsunami debris coming in with, you gotta remember, it's not just the fallout from Fukushima, it's the entire Japanese seaboard that was full of these chemical plants, and these factories, and all of these bad, nasty soup chemicals that have been washed, out to sea by the tsunami and carried through the currents up along the United States of America. They're saying these could get thick enough to actually clog harbors at times and that kind of thing, and this problem is not going to go away for a very long time. So, be advised if you're on the west coast of the United States. You know, I just stay out of that water altogether. Documentary shows simulation of Fukushima melt-through footage of molten nuclear fuel and simulation. You know, we've had 3 confirmed reactor melt-throughs past containment and into the environment. TEPCO finds most polluted fish since Fukushima nuclear accident. A new record set at 740,000 becquerels per kilogram. And they're saying it's harder and harder to find fish to test at all in the little harbor that is Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant right there. TV, very concerned about radioactive contamination on tsunami debris heading to the United States and Canada. Floated through the worst of Fukushima fallout, and it will not wash off. Again, the tsunami debris floated through the worst of the Fukushima fallout, and it won't wash off these isotopes. Some of this debris is highly radioactive, so be very careful on the west coast of the United States. Japan alerts the United States and Canada on possible clogging of shorelines. CNN, tsunami debris makes its way into Hawaii wildlife. Plastic spilling out of the stomachs of these albatross. Some film crews went over to the Midway Islands, which is, you know, way out in the Pacific, and these poor albatross are dying. I mean, their bellies are just full of this plastic crap. And again, it's not just the Fukushima nuclear stuff. It's the melting pot. It's the stew of every chemical crap that was washed out to sea in the tsunami. That's all turning into this big soup in this garbage patch that is out in the Pacific Ocean. Propaganda on U.S. radioactive tuna exposed. The stories have all one thing in common. That is not to panic. They're trying to compare apples to oranges, which is cesium-134 and 137, to potassium iodine you find in your banana, and saying those are comparable as far as your dosages. And again, I cannot stress enough, this accumulates every day. This little bit. A Japanese military unit severely contaminated when Fukushima Unit Number 3 exploded. Too radioactive to stand by each other. Only further heightens the level. So apparently these 6 Japanese soldiers got in a huge dose of the radiation after the Number 3 explosion, and their rates were so high they were told to get the heck away from each other because they were irradiating each other, and it was dangerous for all of them to be in one place at one time. The radiation levels were so high kind of thing. That tends to happen when nuclear things blow up. Japan experts, up to 93 billion becquerels a day may still be leaking into the Pacific from the Fukushima plants. Let me stress again, they are estimating. Now, this is a guess, and you know their guesses are always low. From 8 to 93 billion becquerels a day still leaking into the Pacific from Fukushima plants. The insanity continues and will continue for several hundred thousands of years. Caldecott, California nuclear plant, a time bomb if restarted. Chance of nuke disaster in U.S. very high. Not if, but when. When was 3/11/11? Was it 99 nuclear accidents in the last how long? Safe and green, is it? Scientists, tap water could probably run a lawnmower. It's real gas, 500,000 times legal limit for benzene. I've never seen such high levels. Brockovich visits Illinois community, and there's a whole lot of craziness going on there. She's become very popular lately. I wonder if she's going to run for office. Fukushima woman, I started to suffer health problems one after another, just like the villagers around Chernobyl. And this is just beginning, kids. This is just beginning. Hidden NOAA animation shows ocean all along U.S. West Coast contaminated with Fukushima cesium by the end of March 2011. And again, these are doctored numbers, and they are trying to hide the truth of the actual contamination of the entire planet. Now, this all happened a couple years ago, and it's been ongoing. So it's a wonder why they're acting the way they're acting now. U.S. government model of Fukushima cesium-137 particles covering the northern hemisphere. And again, these are light numbers. Sickened Alaska animals getting more tests for Fukushima radiation. Oozing sores, bleeding, swollen internal organs, and hair loss. Now, they've been studying and testing these poor animals since last year, and those are just the stories we've been finding. And again, they still won't come out with the exact numbers, and we get a big shell game runaround on what's actually going on. But they can't hide it. Man has teenagers over to play with nuclear reactor in his basement. Must wear radiation badges as young as 7th grade. Wants to restock news industries with young employees, of course. There's a couple highlights I want to read off of this. As for the law, Granger is apparently in the clear because the The fusor doesn't use radioactive fuel. It falls under state regulations rather than the Federal Nuclear Regulatory Commission. The Washington Office of Radiation Protection did pay Carl a visit once after a neighbor raised some concerns about his nuclear reactor in his basement. I wonder. Health physicist Mike Brennan inspected the facilities. He saw the safeguards, the shielding on the radiation dose meters everyone wears. I think it's not only safe, but he's teaching safety. So cultural safety is radiating out of his secret lab. Wow, this guy spent all this money to have a little nuclear reactor so he can have teenagers over. Everything's under control, folks. Nothing to worry about here. Over to the Daily News. Fukushima Diaries got a few stories I want to cover today. Salt made from Fukushima seawater sold in Western Japan. I wonder if they conducted the radiation test. I wonder. Evacuee from the nuclear disaster was quoting, "Something yellow fell from the sky like large flakes of snow after the explosion." I will, of course, connect the links to this story. Over 8,000 becquerels a kilogram measured from 18 schools in Yokohama. Newscaster to be hospitalized once again for recurring acute lymphatic leukemia. Now, this guy was having Fukushima vegetables for his campaign of support by eating, and it was suspected to have something to do with the radiation. Suspected? He's been eating Fukushima produce and wonder why he's got leukemia. Where was that one? Japan government to postpone the genomic analysis for Fukushima people for ethical matter. Fish is decreasing in Fukushima plant ports, and fallout levels keep it on increasing. The highest levels since last April, now this is in Fukushima Prefecture, Fukushima City, is increasing trend since last December. And has become the highest since April 15th of 2012. And they've doctored these machines. So the insanity continues, of course. If I've missed anything, please let me know. Attach your comments or videos below. Remember to enjoy what you can. Have fun today. Thanks.
Serious there, folks. You don't understand how that could affect the lives of people in your country, okay, when this kind of thing happens. And yes, it can happen here. I was in the nuclear business for too long. I know all the dirty little secrets, okay? And yes, it can happen here, okay? Trust me. I could tell you some nightmare stories, okay, about people using drugs, alcohol, you name it, while engaged in work at a nuclear power plant.